Now to what is probably the most important thing about a boat review, and that is how well the hull performs. Now, this thing, I've just had it ripping around. It turns like it is on rails. There is absolutely zero cavitation, sideways drift or anything. I can just throw this thing into corners, and yes, great in the flat, but even when I take it out in the rough, it just never feels like it's losing grip. And of course, it's got that legendary Stabycraft ride. Now, some of the earlier Stabycrafts, it was just, almost fluke that they got the hulls working so well. Now they put them through so much testing, and each time a new Stabycraft comes around, they make it that little bit better. This one handles amazing cornering, but equally it's a low planing speed hull, which means if it chops up, you can slow down and still get a fantastic ride. Now, I'm not just saying that. I've been a Stabycraft owner since, last century. 1999, I got my first Stabycraft, and I'll have you know I paid full retail for it. I did my homework, I'd already owned a range of different trailer boats, and I was so impressed with the Stabycraft, I've stuck with them ever since.
That's it!
That's a good fish for shallow water, man!
And I've been fortunate enough to be able to develop a relationship with Stabycraft where I've got to have design input, not just in the big boats, but in the small boats. And when I talk about stability, going out to sea and trusting these boats, the very first little one that I got was the 389. Now, I went out in that 389 Tillisteer, which at the time was a legendary boat that I'd grabbed to just shoot out, do a bit of snapper fishing and do a bit of diving in. And I went out and caught a marlin in that boat.
I don't know if this electric fence reel is going to be able to handle this. Yes! See you back at the boat ramp, bay.
And it was after that boat that I got my first bit of design input, and I asked them about making a centre console. At first I got some resistance. Hey, there's no market in New Zealand for centre consoles. So we took that 389 hull, which I loved, we put a centre console in the middle of it. The balance felt amazing. And on that boat's maiden voyage, the very first time I'd ever taken that boat out, I took it 60 nautical miles off of the west coast of the South Island. Now, if that doesn't tell you how much I trust these boats, nothing will. And I happened to catch a 500 pound tuna on a hand line.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Tuna for dinner!
Oh. And I mean, hey, that was great, but more importantly, everyone seemed to be interested in this new Stabycraft centre console, and since then they have sold literally hundreds and hundreds of centre consoles. So I've had a number of Stabycraft centre consoles, my favourite probably being the 1850 centre console. I love that boat, I caught a whole bunch of fish in that, massive swordfish, all sorts of stuff. I took that boat everywhere and it did everything for me.
It's a huge one, bro, and it did a full flip, bro. Man, you just don't get to see that.
My first side console, which is a bit of change in theory, was the 1550. Now, that boat had a whole lot of fruit on it, and it was very highly specced. This again, back to the 1450 side console, it's a side console again, but it's really basic and standard. It's open plan. I've really simplified it. It's still got all the features I want, but it hasn't got any of the stuff that I seldom used. It is a pretty basic boat, and when we weigh up side console versus center console, the things to consider are space. So this being a side console, particularly with nothing attached to the floor, I've got a lot more space, and I feel I can move around the boat a lot more. One of the things you're trading off if you've got a center console is that you are able to have a bimini top on. With the side console, I just take a buff or wear a big straw hat to keep me out of the sun and out of the elements a little bit. But the center console does take away a lot of that usable functional space, particularly when you're putting quite a few bodies, maybe dive gear, bits and pieces on board the boat. You really want to go for the side console. And the very fact that I'm on a side console right now tells you what my pick is. I'm going for the side console in this side boat over a center console. Once I get a little bit bigger, I might want to go back to a center console again. Anything, say, under 5.5 metres, I really do believe the side console is the way to go. Just for the space, for the easy washdown, and the versatility, which I've already shown you. Once you get a bigger boat, maybe that centre console, and then bigger again, you go to the centre cabin with a full walk around like my 2750. But all of my boats, they have to be safe, they have to be stable, and they have to be able to do what I'm pushing them to do quite a lot. Because I guess underpinning it all, despite all of the rigging and features and things you can do to any boat, the boat's got to have good solid bones, good construction, positive buoyancy, stability, and I'm getting all of those things from Stabycraft, and I have done for over 20 years. And if you do want to see any of those adventures that I've had in all of my Stabycrafts, you might have just seen a few snippets of them, you can watch all of those fishing adventures for free at ultimatefishing.tv.